Whoa, have a look at these. This right here in my right hand, this is a black widow. And this one, this is a brown widow. These are two super famous spiders here in the United States, and their venom has a pretty nasty reputation. And today, I'm going to be talking about which of these two spiders is worse to take a bite from, the brown widow or the black widow. Widow spiders are about the most famous spider species in North America, specifically the black widow. Recently, we came across a brown widow spider, and I figured it would be a good idea to clear up a lot of common myths about these spiders by comparing the two side by side and talking about the effects of their venom. I've already got a brown widow, so all I need now is a black widow. Shouldn't take me too long to find one, though. Yep, there she is. There is our black widow. Now this is the brown widow that we caught in our last video, and this is a black widow that we just went and caught. Both super famous spiders, and today what I want to talk about is the venom of these two spiders. Both of them are notorious for having super bad venom, and that's what I want to talk about today. Now please, don't ever try this at home. You never want to go and try and handle either of these two spiders. The bites from these guys can be serious, and we're going to be talking about the effects of their venom today. However, this is not a try-at-home moment. Now, widow spiders are super famous for having really potent venom, and in actual fact, here in North America, we have 5 different species. And that might shock a few people, but really, 3 of those are black widows. This right here is a southern black widow. We also get western black widows and northern black widows, and those are 3 of them. Another one is the brown widow, which is an invasive species here. And the 5th is the least known one, the red widow spider, which is actually a really, really cool widow spider. They only live in Florida. But today, we're not going to be focusing on the red widow spider or anything like that. We're focusing on these two spiders, the black widow here and the brown widow here. Now, I'm going to go ahead and put the brown widow down for a minute, and we're just going to talk about the black widow. Now, black widows have a really distinct coloration, and they're very easy for people to recognize. Solid black with a red hourglass underneath and a big, big abdomen. It's very easy to recognize this spider. And truth be told, this is probably the most famous spider in North America, and it's kind of considered the most dangerous spider. But really, what really backs that up about this spider is the potency of its venom. It has extremely potent venom, however, it doesn't have much of it. And they have a very specific toxin. It's called latrotoxin. It's named after the black widow spider, and it causes the sickness called latrodectism. Now basically the effects of that are going to be nausea, headache, you're going to feel cramps around the bite site, and it's a really nasty time. And sometimes the effects of a black widow bite can last from 2 to 6 days, and even up to a month in really severe cases. Truth be told, it's really hard to study black widow spider bites. It's really difficult to see when people actually got bit by one, or if it's another different kind of spider that's having a really bad reaction. And you can see, I was handling this guy early. I put it on the stick because it's much more relaxed there. But when I was handling it, it wasn't trying to bite me. They're not an aggressive species whatsoever, and it's only when they're feeling crushed or cornered that they will actually bite. For instance, if I were to grab it and hold it, it would turn around and bite me. Or if it got caught in my clothing, like let's say it crawled up in my clothing and it got squished up in there, that's when a spider like this is going to bite you. They're not going to purposefully bite people for self-defense. Normally it's going to be an accident, or they feel so cornered that their only option is just to bite. Now black widows on average do get larger than brown widows. Even though a brown widow could reach this size, this is normal for a black widow, and this would be very large for a brown widow. So on average they're bigger and they inject more venom, which is a huge factor, not just the potency of venom, but how much venom something has. And widow spiders are so small, they have almost no size to them compared to other spiders. For instance, I'm going to use a genuinely dangerous spider, a Sydney funnel web spider. Those have a bit of size to them. They have big fangs, and they will bite you on purpose. Black widows, really small, tiny fangs, small amount of venom. But it's really, really potent, and that's where these guys really have their issues from. However, dying from one of these spiders is super rare. We haven't had a death from one of these guys in years. Alright, so now we've got the brown widow out. Brown widows are a much less distinct widow species. I mean, look at it. It just looks like a little brown spider right there. Very difficult for people to identify, and easy to misidentify lots of other spiders for this, especially the common house spider, which looks very similar, but doesn't have the same tan lines or the red hourglass on the bottom. Now this brown widow, you can see, a bump smaller than the black widow we just had out, and that's the norm. This is kind of a normal adult brown widow. Even though they can grow to that size, this This is about average adult size. So on average, they tend to be a bit smaller. These spiders are much more shy than a black widow, and really, you might think, well, this is just a brown coloration of a black widow, right? Wrong. This is a totally different spider. They behave totally different. They really are their own thing in a sense. Now, as we mentioned before, these guys are invasive, and we believe that they originated in South Africa and made their way across the entire world. They live in pretty much all the continents except Antarctica at this point, which is pretty crazy. Now, these guys don't have nearly as much venom as a black widow, which instantly brings them down a notch, but another crazy thing is, we genuinely don't know the potency of these guys' venom. You'll see a lot of people, they're more potent than a black widow, they're less potent, and the truth is, we genuinely do not know. And I literally talked to the professional asking about this question this last week, and he said we really don't know. There's not enough studies on it for us to be able to tell whether brown widows have super high potent venom, and there has never been a genuine confirmed death from one of these spiders ever. And that instantly means that the black widow is our winner. So really, this isn't a spider to be super worried about, just one to avoid. If you see one, it's not going to fly at you, it's not going to grab you or anything like that. These spiders are really shy, even more shy than a black widow, and all they want to do is get away from you. The only thing you got to worry about with these spiders is when they get in your clothes, like your shoes on your porch. Just check your shoes, dust them out, make sure that there's not a spider in there, because that's how most people do get bit by brown widows, and that's the only thing to avoid with these guys. Alright guys, so I hope you learned something new today, and we have definitely figured out black widow is much more dangerous than a brown widow, but really the proper term is medically significant. Very few deaths occur from either of these spider species, and they're not something to be scared of. But definitely don't go and try this at home. Far too dangerous, don't try it, and one mess up on my end could ruin my entire week. Really rough stuff. Now hopefully soon we'll be able to film the last widow spider in North America, the red widow spider. Really awesome spider, so make sure to subscribe if you want to see that in the future. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and if you did enjoy, definitely leave a like, and I will see you guys next time. Whew, that's creepy.